everyone, and welcome back to my channel. So in today's video, I'm going to be showing you four different summer-inspired outfits and the places where I wore them. And in addition to that, I'm going to be showing you a really cute summer DIY just to spice up your space to make it a little bit more summery. If you're excited for this video, don't forget to give it a big thumbs up, and let's go ahead and get into it. So outfit number one is a cute outfit that I wore to go get some ice cream, and I went to the Häagen-Dazs ice cream place. Holy moly, guys, this is the best ice cream that I've ever had in my life. They have so many different flavors, and it was just so delicious. I can't even deal. I highly recommend trying Häagen-Dazs ice cream. So the shirt that I'm wearing is from Brandy Melville, and my skirt is also from Brandy Melville. And then I am wearing these cute little shoes from American Apparel. I love wearing little skirts like this in the summertime because they're so light and flowy, like nothing is sticking to you. It just feels nice and airy for a hot summer's day. And what is better to cool you down on a summer's day than some nice ice cream? You really can't go wrong with this. I love this outfit, and I love how easy it is to transition from day to night, so you're really good to go for the entire day with something like this. Take me higher, higher than love. So outfit number two is something that I wore to Griffith Observatory to go and see the sunset there and also just check out the inside because they have so many awesome things in there. And guys, the sunset that I saw here was one of the most beautiful things that I've ever seen in my entire life. There is a gorgeous view of the Hollywood sign and the sunset like right behind it. It was seriously so beautiful. So the top that I'm wearing is from Brandy Melville, and my skirt is from Forever 21, and then I'm wearing the same American Apparel shoes. I love this outfit because even though it concentrates on all black, which you guys know is pretty much my favorite, it has that pop of color with the flowers on the skirt, and just the skirt in general makes it more summer-like. So I think it's still acceptable that I'm wearing mostly black because there are some bright colors on there. In all seriousness, guys, can we just talk about how beautiful the sun is in the background of this clip? I was seriously freaking out while I was there because I couldn't believe how gorgeous the sights in front of me were. It was just the most beautiful thing. So if you can get somewhere up high and watch the sunset, I highly recommend it because it was one of the most beautiful things that I have ever seen, and definitely one of the reasons why I absolutely love living in Los Angeles. And I think going and watching the sunset would be a really cute date destination as well, and I think this outfit would be perfect for a date, so just throwing that out there. If you are going on a date, find a sunset and wear a cute outfit like this one. All I want is an adventure, pull the chains to my head, cause I'm tired of pretending, give me something I won't forget. There must be something in the water. On to outfit number three. So this day I was just shopping at the Grove, so I wanted something really casual but something that would still feel summery. So I just threw this little number together. So my shirt is from Brandy Melville and my shorts are from Urban Outfitters, and I'm once again wearing the same American Apparel shoes. I know, guys, calm down. I know I'm super original and I wear different shoes every day, obviously. Even though this outfit is super basic, it's super comfortable and great for shopping because, you know, when you're shopping, you're wearing like a super complicated outfit and then you never want to try anything on. Well, this is not like that. It's super simple, really easy to try things on while wearing something like this. Plus, I think the white shorts are super summery, so if you can find some white shorts somewhere, I definitely recommend putting them on for the summertime. Why don't you come? And now on to my last outfit. So on this day, I just went to lunch at one of my favorite lunch places with Tara called Fratelli's Cafe. It's on Melrose. If you live in the Hollywood area, I highly recommend it because their food is incredible. Goes out the window, all I want is one. So of course today, I had to go back to my monochrome self. I'm sorry, I know that I don't wear a lot of color, so most of my outfits are not very summery, but you know what? I like what I like. I can't help it. So the shirt that I'm wearing is from Brandy Melville, and the shorts are from Urban Outfitters, and my shoes are from Shoe Dazzle, and my sunglasses are also from Urban Outfitters. They're new. I actually just got them, so if you like them, definitely go and snag them from Urban now. Also, guys, I'm just saying, when I was leaning up against that fence, I got a cobweb all over me. So the things I do for YouTube, just throwing that out there so that you guys know I make sacrifices too. Oh, and if you're wondering, this nail color is from NCLA Nudes Nails, and I will link the exact color down below. So now onto my super easy DIY. This seriously is one of the easiest things you'll ever do. So you're going to start with some tissue paper and a mason jar, and you're going to start with your pink tissue paper, and you're going to cut a triangle out of it. And I definitely recommend leaving it folded. That way you just get a ton of triangles all at the same time that will all be the same size. And then you're just going to line one of them up with your tissue paper and cut out from the green tissue paper what is going to be the top of your watermelons. Pretty self-explanatory. And once you have those all cut out, you can go ahead and start sticking them onto your mason jar. So basically, I'm just taking a triangle and some Mod Podge and brushing it on there. That way the triangle sticks. And then you're going to put some Mod Podge up above the triangle as well and go ahead and stick one of your green strips above there. And voila, you have a watermelon. It's that easy. And basically, you're just going to continue the same exact process all the way around the jar until the entire thing is covered with watermelons. Someone left a comment on my last DIY video that said watermelons are the new pineapples, which is so true because last summer everyone was obsessed with pineapples and now everyone is obsessed with watermelons. Just one of those things, but also saying that I think that this would be really cute with pineapples as well. So if you want to go out there and cover your mason jar in pineapples, I highly support it. And once all your watermelons are dry, you're just going to take a Sharpie and go ahead and draw your seeds on there. That way the watermelons look a little bit more like watermelons and a little bit less like moldy pizzas. And voila, you are done. So as you can see, this is a super simple DIY, and then all you have to do is stick a tea light in there and then light a real candle. That way it actually looks pretty, and voila, you are good to go. I just love this. I think it's so cute and just the simplest way to add a little bit of summer into your home. All in all, I think this DIY probably took me 15 minutes with drying time, so just saying, one of the quickest and easiest DIYs I've ever done on my channel, and one of the cutest, if I do say so myself. And that's it for today's video. I hope that you guys enjoyed it. If you did, don't forget to give it a big thumbs up. And don't forget to check me out on all of my social media. All the links will be right down in the description below. I love you all so much, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye!